You fool! And remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty beer.
Welcome to another edition of Bands, Bikes and Booze Reviews. Tonight, it's Brews Zot. This is a great beer. I've had this before in Bruges, believe it or not. I first tasted this in Bruges and it was a really good experience. I was staying at a hotel, I was doing a gig in Bruges and staying at this hotel. And I said to the fella behind the bar, what do you recommend? And he says, you've got to try this. Never tried it before. This is a few years ago. And he told me the story behind it. And it's a brilliant story. It really is. It's brewed by the Half Marne Beer Company, or brewery, which is based in Bruges. Half Marne means half moon in Flemish. And they brew a couple of other beers, but this is the main one. And it's a great beer. It's a blonde, but a Belgian blonde, if you know what I mean. It's called Brews Zot, with a picture of a jester on the front as a reason for that. Zot in Flemish means fool, and the story goes that in, I think it was medieval times or maybe later, they kidnapped the mayor, I think it was, or the king or someone, and they held him in a castle. And when he was released, he declared that everyone in Bruges were fools. And they adopted the name Zot. But it's a great label, it really is. I do like that label. A picture with a jester on the front. And yeah, and the story goes, well, it's not a story, it's a fact. The brewery crowdfunded the setting up of a system of pipes that run around Bruges, so as they wouldn't have to send their lorries through the cobble streets. If you've ever been to Bruges, or you've never been to Bruges, it is beautiful, it really is. And I really, if you're a fan of beer, I suggest you go there. It's got everything. You'll impress the missus with that as well, because it's reasonably romantic if you're into all that sort of thing. But the beer there is fantastic, and this is a product of that town. And it's, yeah, as I say, they set up a system of pipes around Bruges so as they wouldn't destroy the cobble streets. And the fella in the hotel told me that people started tapping into the pipes and draining a bit off for themselves. But everybody who contributed to the crowdfunding project, they got free beer. I'm not sure whether it's for life, but however much they contributed, they got a percentage back. Which I think is brilliant. That's what I love about craft breweries even. So I'm going to shut up, I'm going to open it, I'm going to tell you what it's like. Alright, so there's the cap off. There is the cap. Very nice. It's got a picture of a jester on the top, or a joker, whatever you want to call them. A fool or a zot in Flemish. Alright, so what's going on here? Banana, clove, and a little bit of spice. But that's about it. This has got yeast in it, and the yeast is very similar to the yeast that you would find in a wheat beer. Well, not similar, but the principle's the same. It will give it a flavour all of its own. So let's just pour this out now. I'll let that settle down for a little bit. It's got quite a nice colour. It's like a sort of a medium golden colour and amber. Oh, I can smell that spice from here. It smells absolutely gorgeous. Let me just tell you a bit about the contents. It is a 330 centilitre bottle and it's a 6% Belgian blonde. So what are we getting? Oh, it's even more banana, even more clove. hint of spice there as well. Coriander, which is quite common in Belgian beers. You get the sort of coriander type aroma. And a little bit of malt in there as well. But it smells nice, it smells promising. I'm going to dive in and have some. Yeah, it's as I remember it. This is cold, by the way, this has been in the fridge. Very, very similar initially on the palate to a Weiss beer. So yeah, similar to the Weiss beer, you're getting a rush of banana, a bit of clove on top of that. But as you swallow, you're getting that slightly spicy sort of note on the top, which is a mixture of coriander and cumin. There's a little bit of cumin there, but there's other sweet fruit in there as well, like peach or something like that. But it's really nice. And then you get a bit of a malty aftertaste afterwards. Like a sweet biscuity malt. It's really good, it really is. Mmm. If you're a fan of Weiss beer, you're gonna like this. It reminds me of a Crystal Weiss. The type that Schneider do, it's that good, it really is. Although there's the slightly spicy note on it as well. It's very subtle. So, you know, when you're drinking it, you have to sort of watch out for it. And then you know what you're getting, you know, with the coriander and the sort of a spice. I tried Leffe recently, or Leffe, however it's pronounced. It tastes similar, but this is so much better. It really is. I don't know whether that's because Leffe's mass produced over here. And this has come from a brewery in Belgium. But it's really good. I really like it. Mmm. It's lovely. And that half Marne brewery from Bruges, they do an alcohol-free zot, and they do a dark zot as well, or a brune, as they call it. I'm going to have to hunt that down and give that a shot, because if it tastes anything like that, it's going to be great. So what would I give that? I love the history behind the brewery. I love the history behind the beer. I love Bruges. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. And I'm definitely going to recommend that, because it is great. It really is. It's a great blonde. Not your typical blonde. It's more of a sort of, it reminds me more of a German style Crystal Weiss, if anything. It's not like your usual Belgian blondes that have got a ton of spice in them. The spice in this is very subtle, but it's there. And it's nice. So it's 8 out of 10, and it's definitely recommended. And remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty beer.
Like and subscribe when a puppy gets it.
Isn't that right, Purse?
Yeah, get off.